Now, finally, we'll begin with what? Your thermal conductivity of rubber. Thermal conductivity of water, of rubber. For our purpose, in our lab, what we'll be considering the rubber to be out of tube. We'll consider what? A rubber tube. Have you seen rubber tube? Have you seen rubber tube? No one has seen rubber tube. Very good. It's just rubber. Okay. Now what you do is, you'll have a container which will be isolated. It will be isolated for a timing. I'm not putting it isolated from the surrounding, let's say, in this manner. Yeah. And over here we have what? Water, which is initially at temperature, initial temperature at theta 3. And over here, what you will do, you will put this rubber like this, rubber tube. Yeah. You'll put a rubber tube and you will take it out from here. And you will blow a steam from this side, and the steam will come out from this side. And this rubber will heat some of the water, as you can see over here. And you'll start noting the temperature by what? Using thermometer. This is a very basic and very simple experiment. Now, first, what you can note the initial temperature. Initial temperature of water when you didn't blow any steam over here. Let's say the temperature at that time is theta 3. Now you will measure the final temperature of water after you blow the steam, and finally the temperature has reached to what? Let's say theta 4. Is it clear? So what will be the inner temperature of the tube? Inner temperature of tube will be exactly the temperature of the steam, because you are sending steam from inside over here. So inner temperature of tube will be the temperature of steam. Clear? Let's write this with what? Theta 1. Let's write this as theta 1 or something. Let's write the inner temperature to be theta 1. So what will be the temperature of outer surface of the tube? Outer surface temperature of the tube will be basically what? Whatever the temperature if the water was over here. So it's basically the average of theta 4 plus theta 3 divided by 2. Is this point clear? Because the tube is sitting over there. So the temperature will be the average of initial and final temperature. Now let's consider the mass of the water was what? Mass of the water was m. And the rise in temperature was how much? It was basically theta 4 minus theta 3. Now the heat gained by the water is how much? Mass times theta 4 minus theta 3. If you remember, it was a what? A specific heat capacity, and W was your what? Work function, if you remember. This is how we did. And the quantity of heat flowing per second will be quantity of heat flowing per second will be how much for the tube we have already done. No, for simply for this one, how much it will be for the water? It will be m plus w q4 minus theta 4 minus per second. It was, so it will be q equal to how much? M plus w theta 4 minus theta 3 divided by how much? Divided by time. Clear? But we know for the cylindrical flow of heat, our thermal conductivity K will be how much? 2.303 times Q log with base 10 R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi L theta 1 minus theta 2. Clear? So from here, what you can substitute Q over here, then you will end up with what? Thermal conductivity to be plus W theta 4 minus theta 3 into 2.303 log of 10 R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi L theta 1 minus theta 3 plus theta 4 divided by 2 times of T. Clear? Because theta 2 was basically how much? Theta 2 was the outer temperature, theta 1 was the inner temperature. So theta 2 was basically how much? Theta 3, the average temperature by 2. So this is the thermal conduct. This is how you find the thermal conductivity of a rubber tube. From here you can find what K. From here K is evaluated. So is this experiment clear? I'm asking to everyone, is this experiment clear? The experiment is extremely simple.
Yes, sir.
You just have a tube, you're just deep in the water, and you just start noting the temperature. That's it. So
yes,
what we are going to do, what? Leidig's method. So tomorrow we're going to start Leidig's method, then we are going to do radiation.